I cannot believe we won that. Like, what the hell? Just when it was a loss, my squad mate actually kills the damn B-17. Not exactly sure how he did. Oh! Okay, now I can stop playing goddamn British for right now. Click okay. Let me order that. Yeah, baby. Goes a lot of my money. And let me take a screenshot. And now let me pause the recording. Alright, guys. So I was really surprised that we actually pulled a victory out of that match. I recorded the entire thing, as I record all of my matches, and there was somebody, one or two people in that match that actually recognized me, if I remember correctly. So if you're watching this right now, then that was the match that we just played. Holy fucking shit, I'm out of breath. Sorry about that. I had to pause the recording and get up and go do something, and now I'm back, and now that I'm talking and not actually breathing, I can't breathe. So let me breathe. Okay. So that match that we were just playing, as you could t well, you couldn't tell unless you saw the results screen, was the preparation match, as most people call it, Preparation H. You know, basically one of the most goddamn annoying maps that you can get in this game. Normally, I don't really mind fighting the United States or fighting the British as the United States. Normally, I mean, fighting the British is more annoying than fighting the US with the British. But what really pisses me off about it is for the exact reason that we were about to lose in that match. And that's because there will always be some bombers, at least one B-17 on the enemy team, that will not drop his altitude. He'll actually climb at the beginning of the match, drop his bombs, and then fly off to the side of the map and just stay there. And continue to climb as best as he can. And even if everybody on your team tries to climb, they'll have to intercept the enemy fighters and then try to climb to keep up with the B-17. And it's absolutely ridiculously almost goddamn impossible to do that. So I noticed that this plane right here, when I loaded onto Grind today, I noticed that this was only 14,000 RP remaining. So I was like, oh, hell yeah, I'll just fly a match or two with the British and get that plane and then switch to another nation. Since I already got the F-84 Thunderjet for the United States, I thought I'd get one for the next nation and then kind of sift around. Because I've been told by somebody who commented that apparently I only have until August 10th before the cut RP cost for some of the jets go back down, or go back up rather. Which I'm hoping that if I work my ass off, we'll be able to actually get our hands on every single jet that's had its price cost, or its RP cost cut. Hopefully. But I can't guarantee anything there. And so, of course, it took us two matches instead of actually one. The first match went all right, and you'd never guess what map it was, the Preparation H match. And how did we lose? Well, it was a defeat, and we lost because there was a B-17 that just sat at the top altitude, continuing to climb, and not actually doing a single thing. And then the second match that we played, same thing, Preparation H, and it led to the same thing. We took down all their fighters and all their bombers, but then there was one left, and it was a B-17, and he wasn't doing shit, and he was at top altitude, climbing, running away from everybody. You know, now, I don't know. I feel like this might be a touchy subject with people. So before we actually talk about this plane, I'm just going to get a little mini rant out of my system right now. I definitely do not know why. I mean, okay, if you're in a bomber, okay, running away from other people, I mean, why wouldn't you, right? I mean, you got to stay alive. You've dropped your bombs, and now you're running away from other people, trying to get back to safety, whether it be friendly fighters or a base, right? So that doesn't bother me if you're running away from players like that. But it's different if you drop your bombs and then climb to top altitude on a map like Preparation H, where the British team will always lose to tickets. See, on most maps, or I'd say most maps, but on some maps, it's not always a timed thing, okay? Like where your team and the enemy team will both have ground targets that need to be destroyed, in order for that team to win. But on a map like Preparation H, the British team only has emplacements, bunkers, pillboxes, stuff like that, while the US team gets columns of tanks, and the AI will push in, destroy our light pillboxes, and take the cap zones in turn winning the match. So no matter what, every single time, the British will lose. The only way for the British to win is to either destroy every single goddamn vehicle, base, and goddamn freaking ship, of which I think there are six, you know, which takes a lot of freaking bombers, or ground attack aircraft, or they have to destroy every enemy aircraft. The United States don't have to do that. The U.S. can easily, if every U.S. pilot just flew off to the side of the map at the start of a match and just stayed there, the British would lose every single time. And that's the only thing I don't like about this map. And that's what the B-17 pilots realize. They don't run away to stay alive. They run away to get an easy victory out of the match. They climb, they drop their bombs right at the beginning of the match, and then they just climb and sit there, and they don't do shit the entire match. They're a complete, just fucking, I don't know what you, toilet paper, but that's not wet yet. They're just sitting up there rolling around, waiting for the match to end, because they know that the match will end with a victory, because it's a timed mission, not a mission based around who can kill the most ground targets, or something like that. I mean, hell, I even loaded out my Spitfire, because the second time around in that match where I ended up unlocking this, I loaded out my Spitfire with ground target 50 cal, ground target 20mm cannon, and a 500-pound bomb, because I knew that there was B-17s that were just going to sit up at the top altitude. I mean, it happened just before that match, and I could already see it happening, so I said I was going to go in ground attack after we had taken down all the fighters. But for some reason, it seems like Gaijin have really screwed around with the ground attacking since the last time I flew in realistic battles. So I apologize if I sound like a complete noob and sane, but for some reason, ground target 50 caliber machine gun cannot destroy medium tanks anymore. 20 millimeter. My 20 millimeter Hispanos, which were one of the best cannons to destroy medium tanks in ground forces, or not ground forces, I'm sorry, in ground attack missions like this, for some reason, I couldn't do shit. And I approached that tank, those Shermans, from every angle. The rear, down low. The rear, kind of coming in at an angle. The just complete top coming down vertical on the Sherman. The side of the Sherman. I've tried 50 cals on the Shermans. I've tried both. It doesn't work. Bloody hell, I dropped my 500-pound bomb right on one of the Sherman right on one of the goddamn Sherman tanks, and it blew up the AAA truck behind it and not the Sherman. So I couldn't help by destroying the ground targets. But in that match, you know, when we didn't know where the last B-17 was, there was four of us left. My squad mate, me, another teammate, and then another teammate. Three of us were ground attacking, my squad mate, me, and another teammate. The other guy was actually climbing looking for the B-17. And since I was getting so sick and tired of this bullshit, I used one of the orders, which I rarely ever do, the blind hunt order, to look for the B-17. Found it. I really love this part. I recorded it. I mean, because of course I record all my matches, but it wasn't really a spectacular match, so I'm not going to upload it. Son of a bitch. I don't know why, but I got goosebumps when I targeted that B-17. Everybody, the three of us that were down ground attacking, everybody just dropped what they were doing and just went straight climbing towards the B-17. For some reason, that gave me goosebumps. I don't know why. Because it's like everybody got off their ass and actually went for the B-17 because I knew. Everybody knows. Like, anybody who plays Preparation H at this tier knows that we will lose if we don't kill that B-17. And it's sad because, you know, like I said, the B-17 players, they don't give a shit. They know that they're going to win the match. That's why they just sit up there and don't do anything. Really, they're not the ones winning the match. The AI is. The only way that the AI can win, though, is because the B-17 just sits around just doing nothing up there. They can drop their bombs, do some damage to a base, and that's it. They're not going to do anything else. The match beforehand, though, which was good, there was three B-17s left. Two of them weren't assholes. They actually dropped their altitude, tried to land, and rearm their bombs. Unfortunately for them, they both crashed on impact. Unfortunately for us, there was one guy that wasn't very respectful and still stayed at top altitude with zero bombs and nothing to do. And it doesn't help that apparently I've been told that bombers have been buffed or something like that. I don't know exactly. I don't know the full details. But I have seen, like, my squad mates attacked multiple bombers in our session so far. And he's died every fucking time. Except for this match. It was actually because of him. We had two Spitfires up there. I had to go back to the airfield because I was almost out of fuel. We had two Spitfires. up there, along with my squad mate, which was a third Spitfire, but he was kind of a little ways back. The two Spitfires, one of them ran out of ammo, so he tried to ram the B-17. He did, and the B-17 didn't do anything, as far as I know. It didn't damage the B-17 at all. And then the other guy shot at the B-17 and then got himself shot down. So I was like, great, we've lost the match. But then, right before our ticket counter hit zero and we lost, my squad mate pulled what would normally be a really stupid maneuver. I didn't see the maneuver, but according to him, he almost stalled out from it. So normally, this would be a stupid maneuver to pull on a B-17, right? You stall yourself out, you lose your altitude, B-17 gets away, and he might even kill you. But it was his last chance to actually win the goddamn match. And holy fucking shit, he killed the B-17, and we won. And it scrounged up enough RP. The reason I didn't get enough RP the first match was because we lost. I only got 8,000 RP. And this time around, since we won, that was more than enough RP to unlock this beauty that you can see on the screen right now, which I have not talked about yet because I've been telling the story of the goddamn matches we've been playing. But I don't know. I just wanted to get that off my mind. I mean, you can report them. That's what the passive behavior report is. It's for when players just stop doing anything in the match and they just don't do anything. So, you know, you can report them for that. But I don't know if anything ever really gets done about it, and I don't think there's anything Gaijin can do about it. Like, how would you put a system in place? Oh, when a player doesn't do anything, it automatically kicks them from the match? That'll hurt more players than it helps, because what about a player that, like, one of us and a fighter that's flying after one of these guys? We're going to get kicked because we're not doing anything. The system can't recognize what's wrong and what's right, which is also why the crew lock system hurts more players than it helps, which I wish they would just completely remove it. I mean, or lower the time limit, for fuck's sake. I mean, come on. But whatever, enough waffling on about, you know, external stuff. Let's actually talk about the plane that I've unlocked. So, I remember way back when we got the first... I don't know how to say it. Because every time I used to say it before, everybody would tell me how it's the wrong pronunciation. I don't know if it's Canberra, I have no idea. So we're just going to be calling it the Tin Can for right now. I remember when I got my first Tin Can... I really loved it, because I really love the B-57, I think is what it's called, isn't it? The United States bomber version. Yeah, B-57. I don't know why, but I just love the jet bombers. They're fun, they're fast, they drop bombs, they die really easily, and they're quite maneuverable. And I know that this one came out not too long after, and this one can actually equip guns. Guns that can help protect it. You can actually see the really obnoxious tumor it's got down here below its butt, which I believe houses cannons. So it's much better than the normal one, because the normal Tin Can can't carry any defensive guns. It doesn't have any defensive gunners and no pilot-controlled weapons. It's just a jet bomber with bombs. This one, however, let's go ahead and open it up here. Look at this. It has four 20mm cannons down here with 2,000 rounds. Normally, I would say this would be a great ground attack aircraft, but for some reason, if 20mm Hispanos can't destroy light pillboxes or medium tanks anymore, I haven't tried it with a light pillbox, so I don't know, then I would find these to be completely useless, and the only use for them would be to attack other aircraft. But that's not how I fly my bombers. You know, I fly my bombers to attack ground vehicles, especially if they have like a B-25. I love that as a ground attack aircraft, not a bomber, because, oh my god, it's awesome. It's an okay speed, battle rating 8.0, so I'm sure that most things are going to outrun this thing and completely destroy it. The rate of climb is absolute shit. The other one always was as well, if I remember correctly. It has zero armor protection, apparently, so no bonuses there. What kind of payload can this thing carry? Let's see. It starts off default with five 500-pound bombs. It can carry up to five 1,000-pound bombs, which is pretty good. Three 1,000-pound bombs and two 500-pound bombs, or two 1,000-pound bombs and three 500-pound bombs. So if you want more variation, I think the one I would always take is... because it looks like you can only carry five bombs at a time, so I would say the best would probably be five 1,000-pound bombs, unless you want to go faster, of course. And of course you've got the 20mm cannons there with all of its different ammunitions that you have to unlock. Nice addition to the collection. I don't know what that adds up to... 111 total vehicles for the British now. The only reason I decided to switch to the British for right now to get it is because all it needed was 12K, or 14K, or I think. 12 or 14K is all it needed left. And you know what? I think I like it, because I do like the Tin Can, at least I used to. We'll have to see how it is now. I'll have to do some more testing with light pillboxes and medium tanks and the cannon ammunition, because, I mean, it's a bit ridiculous though why they would change that, because 50 cals used to be able to wreck light pillboxes and medium tanks if you had the right ammunition loaded. Now, at least with the Spitfire FR Mark 14E, I can't do that. So, as I stated in one of the comments I replied to somebody with, I think the way I'm going to do it is, so I don't focus on one nation just in case I don't get everything, you know, grinded out before the time limit hits, I'm going to get one for one nation, then get one for the next nation, then get one for the next nation, you know, and so on and so on. And so I got the United States one. If you missed that, the previous video, it was the F-84B-26 Thunderjet is what I got. And now I've started research on the F-86. I was going to get this first until I learned that there's only limited time left on the time limit thing. And now I've got the British Tin Can B-I, I guess, Mark 6. I started research on the Meteor F Mark 4. I'm not researching anything that requires 380,000. And you'll notice, if I want to get these things, I have to freaking grind out these two things, but that's probably not going to take too long. And as for the Japanese, I'm so behind on the Japanese tech tree. I mean, look at this. We got a Tier 3, a Tier 3, a Tier 4, and only one Tier 5. At least they don't have much in the way of Tier 5s. I say at least, but they really need more. And a lot of people have sent in on the forums I've heard of. They really want more there. Oh yeah, shit, we got this plane here too that I haven't ground out. Son of a bitch. I think the first one I would go for here is the Japanese ME-262. Oh yes, and of course the Soviets. Can't forget the Soviets. Not sure when I'm going to work on them. I'm going to get the IL-28 first. And the Germans, don't have to worry about them because I've got all their jets. Just a few things here that I got to pick up. And you know what? Basically, I've been flying mostly with a squad mate. Haven't really been flying on my own too much. And so far, I've got to say, I've been really enjoying flying realistic battles again. Even if my aim with the Spitfire is way the fuck off. God damn. If you would have seen the first match when I had to fight another U.S. Spitfire Mark 9, he was like whirling around and I was shooting and I couldn't hit him for shit. And I got him though, after I was like out of ammunition. I basically expended all my ammunition on the damn guy. But anyways, guys, just wanted to share that with you. So here you go. Whoops, I don't want to do that. That is the tin can that has been added to the collection. Wasn't very hard to get since all it required was 14k RP. I really do like this thing that they've done with the RP. I really hope they do this for ground forces someday. Please, Gaijin, if you're listening, you know, I mean, I know I said fuck you to the CEO, but you could totally just make the ground forces, the ground force players a little bit easier for for a little while, you know. Even if it was just for one weekend, if you drop the total requirement for Tier 5 RP things, you know, that would be awesome. Because, my fucking god, as I already explained, the RP gain in aircraft is like 10 times the amount you'll earn in a ground force match, which for some reason, just, I don't know why that doesn't make any sense to me, but whatever, guys. I'm going to go ahead and cut the video off here. You can, if you enjoy the War Thunder Matches aviation episodes, you can probably expect some more aviation episodes soon, whenever we get a nice good match thrown together. Not sure which nation I'm going to be flying next, but you can expect the next Tier 5 unlock probably very, very soon, considering how it's not going too slowly. So guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next War Thunder video.